Welcome students. Today we will be starting with a new topic, that is welded joints. Before actually going for design of the welded joints, let us first go through the theoretical aspects behind it. Welded joints. These joints are permanent in nature, which are obtained by fusion of the edges of the two parts which are going to be joined together. These joints are extensively used in fabrication as an alternate method for casting and forging, and also as a replacement of the bolted and riveted joints. Let us now have a look on advantages of welded joints. The welded joints are lighter than the riveted structures. It provides maximum efficiency, which is not possible in case of the riveted joints. The alteration and the addition of the material are easy in case of welded joints. The welded joints has a great strength. In fact, it has a strength similar to that of the parent material. Circular shapes or any such kind of shapes can be easily welded. This process is also less time consuming than the bolted or riveted joints. Now let us look over the disadvantages of the welded joints. The first disadvantage is it requires a high skill labor and supervision. Because of heating and cooling cycles, additional stresses get developed in the material. Dissimilar metals cannot be welded. So these are the some of the disadvantages of the welded joints. Types of welded joint. The first type of welded joint which we are going to see is the lap joint. A lap joint is a joint which is obtained by overlapping the plates and welding it at the edges. Generally, the cross section of this weld is triangular. These joints are also known as fillet joints. Types of lap joint. Basically, there are three different types of lap joints. First is single transverse lap joint, second double transverse, and third parallel fillet type of lap joint. In single transverse lap joint, the load axis is in the direction perpendicular to the axis of the weld. It is as shown in figure number A. In double transverse joint, again the load is in the direction perpendicular to the fillet, but the weld is on the two sides, one on the above side of the plate and another on the bottom side of the plate, as shown in figure B. In case of parallel fillets, the load axis is in the direction to the axis of the weld, as shown in figure C. The disadvantage of single transverse joint is that the edge of the plate which is not welded can get buckled or distorted. Butt joints. In this case, the joint is obtained by placing the plates edge to edge. Various types of butt joints are square butt joint, single V butt joint, single U butt joint, double V and double U, as shown in the diagram. Apart from lap joint and butt joints, the other types of welded joints are corner joint, edge joint and T joint. Till now we have studied regarding the various types of welding joints, such as lap joint, butt joint, corner joint, T joint, etc. Now, which type of joints should be used on which application? So the selection of the type of welded joints depends on the shape of the object to be welded, the thickness of the object, and most importantly, the direction of the forces acting on the object. Assumptions in design of lap or fillet joint. For calculation and design purpose, it is assumed that the section of the weld is a right angled isosceles triangle. Now let us have a look on the failures of the fillet joint. The figure shows the tensile failure of the fillet joint. From the diagram given, you can see that the applied load is in the direction perpendicular to the axis of the welds. Thereby, the weld will fail in tensile nature as depicted in the given diagram. Another type of failure of a fillet joint is the shear failure. In this case, the load applied is in the direction of the axis of the weld, and because of this, the weld will experience the shear failure. So we have seen the shear and tensile failure of the welded joints. Now to understand at what point or from which point the actual failure take place, let us have a look on this diagram given. From the basics, we know that a component fails from the minimum cross section area. For an isosceles right angle triangle of height h and base h, the minimum cross section area will be at this point. That is, from basics we know that for a right angle triangle, the minimum distance is the perpendicular drawn from the point of right angle triangle to the hypotenuse. So in entire triangle, the minimum distance is this part, ST. So our welding joint will fail about this particular edge, that is T. To find the value of this T, just consider this simple triangle. We have this angle as 90 degree because we have drawn perpendicular. This angle as 45 degree because it is right angle isosceles triangle. Now in this triangle, if I apply cos theta, I will get T as h cos 45. If I use the value of cos 45, I will get T is equal to 0.707 h. Now when we consider the area of failure, we consider the minimum cross section area. Now when this joint will fail, the area will be L multiplied by T because T is my minimum dimension. So for area, I will write area is equal to T multiplied by L, which is the minimum cross section area. So T we have found out 0.707 multiplied by H, L is L. So area will be 0.707 H multiplied by L. Henceforth, we will be using A as 0.707 H multiplied by L. This is just because the welding or any object fail from the minimum cross section area, and the minimum dimension is T in this case, which is also known as the throat of the weld.